This is News 25 with Deanna O'Donnell and Unette Gentry. News 25, local news you can count on. News is brought to you by J.K. Nelson Law. Give them a call, 727-9900. Today's news is also brought to you by Gunny's Air Conditioning and Heating. New service and repair. Call Gunny's, 775-727-6800.
Welcome to News 25 here on KPVM TV and Ace Country Radio. I'm Deanna O'Donnell.
And I'm Unette Gentry. It is Thursday, July 21st.
Well, a man who killed three people while they were on vacation here in Nevada is sentenced in court. Tyler Kennedy was sentenced in Judge Lane's courtroom on Tuesday. The man who killed three people on U.S. Highway 95 will spend up to 60 years in prison for the DUI crash on March 27th of 2021. Kennedy received 8 to 20 years for each of the three counts of DUI causing death. The 34-year-old pled guilty in March after police responded to a report of a person with a gun in an Amargosa mobile home park. Nye County Sheriff's Office deputies, Nevada Highway Patrol, and BLM officers arrived on scene, and he was released after they allegedly found drugs inside his car and commented on police cam video that he appeared to be under the influence. The three victims from Idaho all died on impact. Two children survived with serious injuries. Killed was Michael Durmeyer, his fiance Lauren Starvich, and Michael's 12-year-old daughter, Georgia.
Well, if you're looking for a way to serve in local government, the interim Nye County Clerk position is currently open for those who would like to apply.
On July 19th, the Board of County Commissioners had an item up on their agenda to discuss who will be appointed to this unexpired term of Nye County Clerk Sandra Marlina, who is retiring August 5th. The commissioners reviewed the two candidates running for the position and will be competing on the November ballot. The candidates are Republican Mark Kampf and nonpartisan Daryl Lackey. During the meeting, both candidates spoke about their interest in the interim position. The final decision made by voters in November, in which that the winner will start in January. In the meantime, the county needs someone to hold the seat.
I want to do this position because I want to serve all the voters of Nye County, regardless of their party or political affiliation in any way. My belief is that we have an office that has been exemplary in its integrity, and I want to maintain that level of integrity that Sam Merlino has exhibited in her term. I believe I have the skills, the background, and the intellect to be able to step into the job on day one. My experiences as treasurer have given me experience in the processes and the procedures of the county, which will allow me to function in that role very quickly. There's an election to be dealt with, and you want to make sure you have the right person in there to conduct that election without any fault or any missteps whatsoever. And I look forward to your appointment to that position. Thank you.
The reason I'm running for office is because our country's falling apart. You can't come back from communism. That's for sure. You can't come back once it's gone too far. We're losing things every day. Every day we're losing things. And it's because of the Republican, Democrat nonsense that we're fed down from the top. You have to be one or the other. You got to choose the lesser of two evils. This is what I've lived my whole life, listening to people. And then finally, when I get involved with it, I'm not going to be one of those. I'm going to give people an option to vote for that's not one of the evils. We know that the Republican and Democrat parties are evil. We know that. That's a given. Not down at our level. We joined the. I was a Republican. I became a state delegate for the Republican Party while I was running for county clerk, county commissioner in 2008 and 2012. And I ran for county treasurer in 2010. I got 1,600 votes, but that was one of the recount times. And we went to recount, and the voting rolls are just these tiny little rolls with rubber bands around them. Not one full-size roll that you would imagine from the machine where it prints it, goes down. So that's why I'm nonpartisan.
The Board of County Commissioners will decide on the regular meeting August 2nd. The county is opening up the position to all interested applicants, and they are requesting letters of interest and resumes from any qualified individuals to fill the temporary vacancy, including the deputy clerks. This interim position will take effect August 5th and will end in January of 2023. The application deadline is Wednesday, July 27th. Commissioner Donna Cox spoke during the meeting and states that the election will not be fair if we appoint one of the two candidates without looking at more applicants.
So if we're going to have a fair election, we're not going to have a fair election by appointing one of these people over top of the other person. The only way we're going to get a fair election is if we put somebody in that wants to apply for the job that is not running for office right now. And we did have a person speak up and say they're willing to take that position. And I know they're not on the agenda today, but we also did not put this out to the public. And I don't think that is fair, and I don't think that is right. And I'm just trying to allow both of these people an equal chance to go out to the people and have those people vote for their choice and not be putting somebody into an office now, basically, that's going to have an unfair advantage because we did that.
During this meeting, Commissioner Bruce Jabor spoke to each candidate about possibly holding a joint position as co-clerks for the temporary job.
And I will ask the same question to Mr. Lackey. It is unusual that we have both candidates that have interest in this position at this time. And we certainly don't want to give an unfair advantage. So my question to you is, would you be able to work as a co-county clerk with Mr. Lackey?
I frankly believe that that would be quite difficult, and I would not see that as a viable alternative.
I love the newness of that idea. That's the way to go. That's it. Yeah, no problem.
To apply for this interim position, you need to be a qualified elector and a Nye County resident. If you are interested in applying for this vacancy, you can submit your letters to the Nye County Administration Office at 2100 East Walt Williams Drive, Suite 100, in person no later than Wednesday, July 27th. And that is Wednesday, July 27th.
All right, stick around. Much more local news for you when we return.
You're watching News 25, the most recognized and farthest reaching local news in Nye County. News 25, local news you can count on. This segment of News 25 is brought to you by Lisa Spahitz and Mike Plasmeyer at Country Financial Insurance, auto, home, life, and commercial, 775-727-8920.
Welcome back. Well, yesterday we told you about a proposal for a solar farm off of Basin Avenue that was on the beginning of July Board of County Commissioners agenda. Well, yesterday that item was up in front of the board again. The Nye County Commissioners had an item on their agenda concerning a proposed 100-acre solar plant located near Basin Avenue, Betty Avenue, and Barney Street here in Pahrump. Commissioners directed staff to write a letter of support at the January 5th meeting, which they were hoping to approve on the January 19th meeting. Commissioners had voted against solar farms in the past, though they want to support renewable energy. They have made statements in the past that solar farms should not be near populated areas in the county. Con Edison is proposing a farm in close proximity to housing, but on privately owned property to tie in with Valley Electric Association's power grid. It's unclear if this power will be used locally or sold elsewhere. Commissioner Deborah Strickland said she was against solar farms on BLM land, but not privately owned.
Because if we do, we've got a pretty good solution to the problem we have right now, which is all this BLM stuff.
I have a question.
Yeah, that's what I have for you.
Is that a motion?
No, I'm just giving a general comment at this time.
Okay,
so the board could understand what I'm thinking.
Planning Director Brent Wagner says that they have prepared the letter of support.
That was my understanding with that resolution, was that it was for public lands, not private lands. But again, you're sitting as two different boards here. And in order for them to proceed with the SUP process, this is a requirement. So that's the only reason you're here.
Right.
As far as public hearings and future discussions, yes, it'll come through three public hearings, two for the zone change, one for the SUP. So there'll be plenty opportunity as a board to address as the county board. But it's a recommendation in your letter that as things move forward through processes, that information is going to be brought forward in better detail than just a verbal statement up at a microphone. Do what you wish. This was a direction and an ask to draft a letter for you guys. I think you had already determined you were going to issue this letter, and I think it's just to approve this draft the way it is. So I don't know how much rehashing you guys want to do on that.
In the end, the vote died to send the letter of support, and Con Edison will now need to move forward with the process without it.
Nay.
So it dies.
And in other local news, Nye County Sheriff's Office deputies arrest a man after he is suspected of driving under the influence.
Nye County Sheriff's Office arrested an Arizona man on Sunday, July 10th of this month for allegedly driving erratic and pulling a firearm on the reporting party. Deputies say the suspect appeared to be intoxicated, as evidenced by his bloodshot, watery eyes, confused speech, and distinct body odor of alcohol. The suspect admitted to being intoxicated 30 minutes prior to him being detained. Deputies took Mark Mabry into custody for being in actual physical control of his vehicle while under the influence of alcohol. The suspect was transported to the Nye County Detention Center.
Well, there have been three COVID-related deaths confirmed and reported for the past 2 weeks, ending on July 18th. All are residents of Pahrump. There's 121 new COVID-19 confirmed positive cases here in Nye County for the past 2 weeks, with three in Smoky Valley, two in Tonopah, and the remainder right here in Pahrump. Total, 6,952 confirmed cases of COVID-19 since the first one was reported. You must remember that these cases are the ones that are actually reported to the health department. That does not include home testing, in which most testing is conducted at home. And Beatty Community Center is having a COVID vaccine clinic on July 23rd. They're going to be having that at their location, 100 West Knight Avenue, from 10 to 4. July 24th in Amargosa Valley, you can go to the Amargosa Valley Community Center from 10 to 4, 1640 East Amargosa Farm Road. July 30th here in Pahrump at Pahrump Valley High School from 9 until 1 p.m. at 501 East Calvada Boulevard. And the COVID vaccine is also available Monday through Thursday here at the Pahrump Community Health Nurse's Office at 1981 East Calvada Boulevard by appointment only. You can give them a call, 775-751-7070, and leave a message to get your schedule. Also, they are reminding people to get your child up to date on immunizations for back to school or just in general. Parents or legal guardians may call that Community Health Nurse's Office at 775-751-7070. And they say if you leave a message, someone will call you back. Of course, you can also call them for any other information that you may have. They also take private insurance, and there's free at-home testing kits available at most of the town offices in our area and health nurse facilities. Or you can go to covidtest.gov on the web.
And if you're thinking about using a digital voice assistant, you have several choices out there. Today, Josh Osborne from Great Computer Deals here in Pahrump is giving us tips for what you need to consider.
Hi guys, Josh Osborne with Great Computer Deals. It's time for another quick tutorial, viewer question edition. One viewer asks, what's the difference between OK Google and Apple's Siri? To be honest, not a ton of difference. OK Google is obviously Google's voice assistant, and it's going to work best if you're using an Android phone or Google smart home devices. Siri is simply Apple's voice assistant, which accomplishes many of those same goals, but only works with Apple products. Don't forget, Amazon has Alexa, Samsung has Bixby, and there are many others. They're all trying to do the same thing, but should be chosen based on the type of hardware you're using. Pick the one that is most compatible with all of your electronics. Why trust a technician when you can trust a friend? Great Computer Deals is located at 1190 East Highway 372. Call us at 775-990-8833.
Thanks so much, Josh.
Yes. All right. We'll be right back with your sports right after this break.
You're watching News 25, brought to you by Mountain West Lawyer, Injury Attorneys.
727-9500. Also brought to you by Silver State Health. Visit silverstatehealth.org or call 702-471-0420 for an appointment. News 25, local news you can count on.
All right, we're going to go to your medical minute right now.
This medical minute is brought to you by Spring Mountain Medical, healthcare the way you've always imagined it.
Hi, I'm Troy Perkins with Spring Mountain Medical, your hometown health and wellness provider. Today, I'm going to talk about ADHD in our children and young adults. ADHD, or ADD, is a condition in which a patient exhibits symptoms or behaviors such as attention deficit, hyperactivity, and inability to focus. Anger and irritability can also be signs your child is dealing with this condition. Treatment for people living with pediatric ADHD include, but not limited to, therapy, medication, or a combination of the two. Children with ADHD under my care gain focus and clarity. Let me help your child's performance in school, sports, relationships, and everyday life by giving our office a call today and scheduling a consultation. I'm Troy Perkins, and this has been Your Medical Minute, brought to you by Spring Mountain Medical.
All right, thanks so much. And now here's Katie Fretter with your sports report.
Hi everyone, my name is Katie Fretter with your KPVM News 25 Sports Report. Today I will be updating you on your favorite preseason and in-season teams here in Las Vegas. All this and more in today's Sports Report. The Vegas Golden Knights traded Max Pacioretty to the Carolina Hurricanes with defenseman Dylan Coughlin for future considerations. Pacioretty was one of the great players on the team and appeared in 224 games with the Golden Knights. Max Pacioretty was acquired by the Vegas Golden Knights prior to the 2018-2019 season. The Vegas Golden Knights have signed forward Riley Smith to a 3-year contract with an average annual value of $5 million. Smith has appeared in a total of 686 NHL games. Riley Smith was acquired by Vegas from the Florida Panthers back in 2017 during the NHL expansion draft. The Vegas Golden Knights have also signed 4 more forwards. Brett Howden, Jonas Ronjerg, Sheldon Rempel, Byron Froese, and goaltender Michael Hutchinson. The Vegas Golden Knights and the Las Vegas Raiders battled it out in a charity softball game at the Las Vegas ballpark on Monday. The Golden Knights team Riley Smith defeated the Raiders team Josh Jacobs. The score of the game was 27-20, and the Knights' William Carlson was named the MVP. According to the Golden Knights, over $200,000 was raised for charity this year. The Las Vegas Raiders rookies, first-year players, and quarterbacks arrived at training camp on Monday, July 18th. The rest of the team will arrive on Wednesday and have their first practice on Thursday, July 21st. The Las Vegas Raiders have signed wide receiver Isaiah Zuber. Zuber originally signed with the New England Patriots as an undrafted free agent in 2020 and has appeared in 4 career games. The Vegas Silver Knights have signed 2 forwards, Gage Quinney and Kyle Marino, and 2 defensemen, Jake Bischoff and Brandon Estes, to AHL contracts for the 2022-23 season. Kelsey Plum signed a 2-year extension with the Las Vegas Aces on Sunday, July 17th. The Las Vegas Aces beat the New York Liberty on Thursday, July 14th with a score of 108-74. The Aces also beat the Connecticut Sun on Sunday with a score of 91-83. On Tuesday night, the Aces lost against the Atlanta Dream with a score of 92-76. The Las Vegas Aviators won 2 out of the 6 games against the Salt Lake Bees last week. The Aviators play again this Friday, July 22nd, against the Texas Round Rock Express. The Las Vegas Lights won on Sunday, July 17th, against the RGV Toros with a score of 1-0. The Lights play again this Saturday, July 23rd, against the Oakland Roots. For your KPVM News 25 Sports Report, I'm Katie Fretter.
News 25 WeatherCam is brought to you by Lerner & Rowe Injury Attorney's Office in Pahrump. In a wreck, need a check? Call 702-877-1500.
Taking a look outside at some of that traffic there on Highway 160 because of the road construction.
Yes, look at that. And traffic plus the heat, that's a lot of temperatures rising.
News 25 weather is brought to you by Dairy Council of Nevada. The splash of cream in your coffee, the dollop of sour cream on your burrito, the melted toasty cheese on your pizza. Undeniably delicious, undeniably dairy. Enjoy what's real.
Hi, good evening, Nevada. It's John Kohler from the KPVM Channel 25 Weather Studios. Great to see you on a Thursday. And what a weather map we have to present to you. Look at this, 101 degrees in Fernley and Fallon. Weather twins, look at you go. Carson City hits 96 today, 95 out in Tonopah. That's the cool spot. 97 in Goldfield. Beatty at 105, excessive heat warnings. Amargosa, 111 degrees, excessive heat warnings. Las Vegas, oh, good golly, 112. You're the winner chicken dinner today, but you win an excessive heat warning. Ta-da! Yay, good for you. 122 out in Death Valley. And here in the Paradise Brump, excessive heat warning. Oh, danger, danger, Will Robinson. 107 degrees. It was 108 just a little bit earlier. Southwesterly winds to 11 miles per hour. Kind of, you know, put some convection in the air, I guess. That humidity wasn't at all present. 10%. My gosh. Sun rose this morning at 542. Setting this evening at 7:57, it's a great time of day for the sun to set, and a great name for an airplane. A low tonight of 80 degrees. We'll check out those winds at 7, 8 miles per hour out of the southeast. Humidity at 15%. It's kind of building as we head into the weekend, and what do we see? A bunch of clouds. Bunch of clouds. Look at all those clouds. 109 degrees, 107 the next couple of days with those excessive heat warnings. It'll calm down somewhat on Sunday. Check out Monday.
All right. Well, we did want to let people know that that road construction will be ending at the end of this month. And they're pretty much done with the northbound, southbound, working on it right now.
That's right.
We'll see you back here tomorrow. I'm Deanna.
I'm Unette.
Good night.
Good night.